G'day, welcome back to Build Some. What I want to talk about today is what we call a grid survey. So a grid survey is commonly used where we want to know the contours of our site. It's just a survey of a regular grid on the site, so we can then work out the contour lines. So the first thing we're going to look at is the actual grid survey. So on your site, what you need to do is break the site up into an even grid, and this is generally about 5 meters by 5 meters. It could be 10 by 10 depending on the size of the site, but obviously the smaller the grid the more accurate, but also the smaller the grid the longer it's going to take. And with the scale of the drawing you're going to produce, you know, going too small is really not worth the effort. So about 5 by 5 is a good size for the grid. So you have to break your site up into the 5x5 grid. Try and be as accurate as possible. You can measure this distance in. Once you have a couple of points established, you could eye the points, and you're just going to need to mark the ground somehow with spray paint or scratch a mark on the ground with your foot, just so you know when you go around with your staff where all the points are. However you do it doesn't really matter, as long as you come up with a nice even grid that you can take your levels from. Obviously we're going to have to identify all these points later so we can transfer them onto our plan. So it's a good idea to make a sketch of the site, label them, number them across the top, letters down the side. So this point becomes A1, A2, B3 here, C4 here, so you can identify each point. And then it's just a matter of getting out there with your staff and taking a reading at each of these points, making sure of course that you record them on the level book and that you then work the level book out and produce the reduced level for each of these points. And you can watch my videos on those if you need to brush up on doing a level book. But what you want to end up with is a reduced level for each of these intersections. And wouldn't not a bad idea, when you've finished your level book, transfer the RLs into a chart like this, or you can just transfer them directly onto the site plan. So now we've got our site plan with our RLs recorded for each of these intersections. So that's the basis. So that's basically a grid survey completed, and that's the basis of what we need to start to work out our contour lines, and that's what I'll look at in the next video.